Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, the team of Achieve IAS is announcing a brand new series in which what we will be doing, we will be daily discussing the important editorials that might have appeared in different newspapers and not just restricted to one newspaper. So the newspapers that will be covered by us will be Indian Express, The Hindu, The Tribune, and any other article that is important from any other newspaper. So friends, before starting discussion, let me tell you that this discussion will be a very short discussion. So I will not be giving you minute details about the editorial, but I will be giving you an overall idea so that you can read yourself and so that you can be able to better comprehend once you read yourself, because self reading is the most important thing. And my purpose is here not to give you a very to explain the meaning of each and every line that is given in the editorial, because it also amounts to the waste of time of me as well as of you people, because you also have to do multiple things. For example, you have to read newspaper, you have to cover general studies, you have to read optional papers, and then you have to attempt the answers, so that consumes a lot of time. So the purpose here will be a very short and crisp discussion. So if you are willing to learn through this short and crisp discussion, then you are more than welcome on our channel. So let's start our discussion, friends. So today we will be discussing two articles, and that they are taken just from Indian Express. So actually we had to discuss the other newspapers also, but due to some other work we were not able to cover other newspapers. So today we will be discussing just two editorials, and they are from Indian Express. So the first editorial, the heading of which is "Let the Farmer Earn." So as is clear from its name, it is about the farmers and their incomes. So this is the article is written by Harish Damodaran. This article was there in today's Indian Express. So what all this editorial says? In short, it says that the measures that the government is adopting, for example, recently you might be aware that onion prices have gone up. So in that context, government of India has taken multiple measures. For example, minimum export price has been fixed, and then MMTP has been asked to import the onions below the import parity. So multiple efforts have been taken. So here in this article, the author discusses that how these steps are short term and they are harming the interest of the farmers. So author starts by one single line, that is, when money is bad, people want it to be better, but when it is good, they think of the other things. So here the author says, just replace this money word with onions. So because this when onions are bad, people want them to be better, but when they are good, they think of other things. So what does it mean? So basically, in detail, we will not be going into detail. So here the author has been discussing the multiple data, the prices of the onion in different seasons. But simple thing is, the author wants to say is, when the prices of onions are low, then the government and everybody is okay. But the minute it goes up, then government becomes hyperactive, and then the consumer also starts feeling the heat. But then the author says that the consumer can't be blamed, because obviously it has also its vested interest. But here the government must balance the interest of the consumer as well as farmer. So this policy, according to the author, that is doing little when producer prices are low for extended periods, but then jumping into action at the slightest hint of consumer despair, that is often temporary. This translates into a one-sided bet against the farmer. So this is the kind of a bet which harms the interests of the farmers very badly, because for quite a long time the prices of onions remained subdued in the beginning of this year as well. But the minute it started jumping, then the government came into action. So there are multiple things which the author here discusses, that for example, there has been substantial losses that have been incurred by farmers due to these low prices. So you can read the data yourself by when you will be reading editorial. So here the author also highlights this policy in the context of your Milk products as well, because here the author talks about the proposed regional comprehensive economic partnership deal in which India is expecting to open up its market for the free imports of duty-free imports of different milk products from New Zealand and Australia. So the author is saying that what this will do, obviously when there will be kind of, we can say, this as the farmers now are earning quite well from this dairy sector, but when this India's market will be opened up under this regional comprehensive economic partnership proposed agreement, then obviously there will be dumping of the dairy products from other countries in India. So obviously, who will get the benefit of it? Ultimately, the benefit that will be gained, it will be by the consumers and the farmers. They will obviously incur losses, because the excess supply would certainly reduce prices and it will harm the interests of the farmers. So obviously that will obviously take away from them the minimum income that they are earning, hard earning that they are making. So obviously with the surplus moon rains delivering a bumper harvest, so it is as you might be aware that this year was a surplus monsoon rain, so obviously bumper harvest is expected. So definitely in Rabi season there will be bumper harvest, so farmers incomes that offer the best hope for an economic turnaround. So it is the obviously you people might be aware that our economy is facing a slowdown. So obviously that slowdown is due to lack of demand. So obviously rural demand is an integral part of aggregate demand that the country has. So if the farm and rural areas, mostly people are dependent upon agriculture for their living. So if there is a bumper harvest and they are earning well, then that could be a best way to revive the economy. But by taking such measures, the Modi government may hurt the farmers' interest as well as the interests of the economy. So the consumer, in fact, the authors in the end says that the real friend of the consumer is producer, because it is ultimately the producer who will produce and in sufficient quantity so that the prices do not rise. But when we must then ensure that this interest that is of the consumers as well as the farmers, that interest is balanced, because obviously if there is economic turnaround, then only the jobs can be protected, and also the entire economy will kickstart. So this is about this article. So friends, you might have seen that I haven't discussed much in much detail. So that is I think the best approach, because there will be no point discussing in each and every line. So my responsibility is to give you just an idea, because ultimately you have to form your own opinion while reading the article. So my purpose is to just give you an idea and not to give you in detail explanation. So now let's move on to the second article. So it is also related to the onions. So wipe away the onion tears. So this article is also quite similar to which has been discussed by us in the recent article that has been discussed by us. So here again the authors say that onion prices are high, and again the government has become hyperactive. So what the government has done, government has kind of raised the minimum export price to 850 dollar per ton. So obviously then also team of bureaucrats has been built to be sent to the Lasal Gaon, that is the India's largest wholesale market of onions, to assess the entire situation. So if this team comes out with the suggestions like increasing imports and imposing stocking limits and then blaming onion traders for speculation, so it won't be a surprise. So onion prices, obviously again the author says that when the onion prices were quite low, so the government was not active, but as soon as the spike happened, the government became hyperactive. So obviously what this shows, that this shows that India's agricultural policies suffer from an inherent consumer bias. So agri price policy, not we can say agricultural policies, but agri price policies are tilted in favor of the consumer and against the interests of the the farmers or the producers. So also then MMTC has been asked to import the duty free onion. So that will basically this step has been taken to basically dump the onions below their import parity to prices to tame the domestic prices. So here the author says that this approach that has been adopted by the government, so it is not a long-term measure, because basically this approach that has been adopted by the government in case of not just onions but also of other crops, this is not only anti-farmer but it is also against the agri exports which we aim to enhance, because obviously our export policy is also highlighted the importance of agriculture export, and we want to increase our agricultural export in to double the farmers' income as well. So these steps are against these goals that have been set by the government itself. So it is contrary to the vision of also the Prime Minister's vision of doubling farmers' income. So this must be avoided at all the costs. So why the authors are raising concern? Because obviously, friends, you must be aware that markets are not built in a one day. So if you are selling a product, you must gain the reliability of the consumer. So the consumer must have faith in you. So obviously, this is particularly important when it comes to export. So export markets are not that easy to capture because they are excessively competitive, and also the consumer markets they check the reliability. So such abrupt measures of the government, what they do, they not only do the harm to the farmers' income, but they also deprive them of the important export markets, and then turn them into unreliable producers, and then this hurts the interest of the farmers as well as the government vision. So in this context, what can be the solution? Because we have already discussed the issues. So solution here, three solutions have been proposed by the authors. So first solution is about the NAFED. So NAFED has been tasked, it is said by the authors, it has been tasked to control the prices, to stabilize the prices. So what it can do? So obviously in the months that is of September and August, obviously the production also due to seasonal variations, season changing, the availability of onions is always less. So what the NAFED can do in the beginning of year, the NAFED can procure these onions at a just price, and this will ensure that the farmers get also proper price of the price of their crop, because obviously at that time farmers who earn just 4 to 8 k per kg, they will get 12 to 15 k per kg if the NAFED procures them, and then it makes such procurement available in the months when there is a lean season. So in that context, it will save the farmer's interest as well as the consumer interests. And then again, here the author says the second solution that is proposed is the reform in agricultural produce marketing committees. So the author say that their field visits suggest that and their analysis of the data shows that only 29% of the price that is paid by the consumer realized by the farmers. The rest of the 71% share is utilized by the middlemen, the strong traders that control the agricultural produce marketing committees, where the trading of onions, majority of the onion production takes place. So here in case of these APMCs, there are powerful traders that have formed their interest organizations, and then there are commission agents. What they do, they excessively impose different cesses or fees, which potentially increases the price, and also then the actual realization of the price is not of the farmer but of the retail marketers who sell these onions. So this reveals that our agricultural produce marketing committees have to be reformed. So auctioning procedure is controlled by powerful traders and commission agents with much less bargaining power for farmers. So there are layers of mandi fees and commission escalate prices further, because when prices increase, so price will be ultimately will have to be borne by the consumer, but then value addition doesn't take place. So unnecessary fee is mandi fee is imposed and other commissions are imposed. So it reveals that these actual commissions are way above the prescribed charges. So officially they are levied on the buyers, but ultimately this again, the burden of this has to be borne by the farmers. So what this indicates is that the reform of agricultural produce marketing committees must also take place. So two reforms have been covered, that is NAFED must procure, and then agricultural produce marketing committees have to be reformed. And third thing is that the author suggests is the Ministry of Food Processing and Industries. So then there is a thing that is called dehydrated onion. So basically it is a powder, or we can say flake or granules. So what this dehydrated onion, they have the same taste when they are used for preparing a recipe. Then the author suggests that we must promote the use of such dehydrated onion powder. So that is the responsibility, according to the authors of the Ministry of Food Processing and Industries. So such use can ensure that in the months that are lean, in which the onions are not available, then these such things such processed dehydrated onions can be used, so that the prices do not rise above a just limit. So this will also reduce wastage, because obviously a thing that is dehydrated has longer shelf life, and also it will ensure that the farmers get a fair price and consumers can switch to these dehydrated onions in the lean season at affordable prices. So if the government can take these steps, it will not only know its onions but also farmers. So this is about your discussion of today. So both the articles were relating to onion. So you will be getting tomorrow's video in the morning itself by 9 a.m. So we will be continuing this series now, and we will be discussing daily articles from different newspapers. And if in case you like this discussion, friends, and if you liked our video, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And also, friends, your comments, your observations, your feedback is most welcome. We will be looking at it, and we will be welcoming any constructive criticism or feedback which you can give in the comment box. So this is all about today's video. Thank you, friends. Have a very nice day ahead.